Welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we will discuss about the information architecture. Okay, so please subscribe our YouTube channel so that you can get more updates from our side, and please press the bell icon button so that you can get instant notification from our channel. So guys, in this video we will discuss the information architecture's basics, and in our upcoming lectures we will discuss about its types, the types of information architecture, why there is a need of information architecture in software industries, and the varieties of information architecture, its models, and etc. So please subscribe us so that you can get all the necessary updates from our channel and you can learn with us. So guys, let's start. The first is organizing content or objects. Okay, so first, the information architecture is all about the organizing content or objects, describing them clearly and providing ways for people to get to them. Okay, so information architecture is basically the systematic way of presenting the information, or the systematic way of presenting the information related to the people's requirement or related to user's requirement, that what user wants. So according to the user or client, we have to present the information in a systematical way. So what we have to do to achieve that requirements or that purpose, organizing content or object. Suppose if you went to any grocery or supermarket, their items, all items are organized in very well manner. Suppose if owner wants to expand that model or expand that grocery items, then what he suggests, that please organize them accordingly so that user can find each and every type of things very easily. Okay, so very easily, once one have to find the need of there. So for that we have to organize content or objects. So information architecture, the first point is organizing content or objects, means we have to organize the content in very well manner. The second one is describing them clearly, means after organizing we have to describe them clearly. Suppose we are taking example of supermarket, so suppose if you are going into kitchen kitchens or kitchen grocery, then what you have to find there, you have to find there the items of your cook crockeries, or maybe some items of foods, or maybe you can get some items like masala, like that. So we have to describe each and area clearly, that what will you get in this particular thing, at the particular area or at the particular site, what will you get. So to make, after organizing we have to describe them clearly. It's very important point under information architecture. The third one is providing ways for people to get to them. Now after describing, we have to provide ways, means how people or user can use that easily, means we have to take them or we have to make them use by indicating them the necessary updates or necessary hints, that in the section 1, suppose in library there is organized books are there, then they describe that this is a science area, this is computer area, like that. And they provide the ways, means in rack 1 you will get the books of these subjects, in rack 2 you will get the book of these subjects, like that. So after organizing and describing, it's very necessary to provide the ways for people to get them, because you have to know that point, that content is king but distribution is a queen. So according to this theory, we have to make providing ways for people to get used to them. So it is basic of information architecture, that what information architecture is all about. In our next lectures we will discuss about the types of information architecture, their need, and many more. So please subscribe us guys so that you can get more updates from our site. Thank you so much.
Welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we will discuss about the areas of information architectures, means what are the key areas of information architecture, or simply we can say that the types of architectures. Okay, so guys, please subscribe our channel so that you can get more updates from our channel, and please press the bell icon button so that you can get instant notification from our channel. So guys, let's start with our today's topic, that is the types or areas of the architecture. Okay, so the architecture applies to the various aspect of the architecture is applied to the various aspect of the software system development. Okay, so the software architecture is applied to various aspect. What are the aspects of software system in this architecture is used, means to simplify that classification of an architecture we will learn here from its context basics. So types of architecture is the first one, the type of architecture is application based. The second one is business, in which you can say that the applications, what are the applications based type architecture is the email, memos, idea matrix, task, to do matrix, alert matrix, address book matrix, browser, phone lock, calendar or clipboard. These are all under the application types of architecture. Okay, so the types of architecture is application. We will expand this further, but here we are just taking its intro. The second one is enterprise. So it's used in enterprises management like compliance, policy, technology, in any industry type manner. Okay, now hardware architecture is also there, that how will you concentrate on its hardware parts. Infrastructure architecture is also there, that how do you make the infrastructure type manner. Then network architecture is also there, that how do you manage network architecture of any industry or any organization. Then platform architecture is there, that how do you design the platform for your industry or security services, whatever there. Then performance architecture is there, that how will you calculate or analyze the performance of whatever the industry or organization you are working for. Then security architecture is there, that how do you design the security architecture so that no one can from outside can steal your data, or you have to protect that data, so you have to make the architecture according to your security of the industry. Then we have to make all the solutions of that. So it is a software architecture, then system architecture. So we will discuss all of them. Okay, so we are just taking here a brief analysis or brief intro. Okay, so that what's there. So technical type of architecture is also there, technology type architecture is also there. Then web architecture is there, that how would you design the website, what the content it will have, what's necessary to show the user and what's not, so like that. Then data architecture is there. Data architecture is very important aspects of, because the you can maybe heard of the Hadoop or the big data, that's very important aspect from today's point of view. Then information, today's too much information is there, so to make that information visualize for the user and to make information to convey the real message that what they want, so it's also there. So we will discuss each and every type of information architecture here. Okay, so let's start. The first one is enterprise architecture. Okay, so what's the enterprise architecture? Enterprise architecture is concerned with mapping the business processes and needs to the technical capabilities of the organization, including personal strategy, distribution, and how the business changing needs will be met. Okay, means enterprise architecture is concerned with mapping the business processes. Generally, it's used in the business processes, that how business processes are concerned, or the needs of the technical capability of the organization, which will include the personnel or strategy or distribution, and how the business changing needs will be met. So this all will be covered in the enterprise architecture. You can see that the business services is there, then it's an organizational, and we have divided business processes and organizational structure. Then interoperability, consistency and efficiency is there, people, processes and technology is there. Then the vision and strategy of one business service is there. Okay, now the second one is system architecture. What is the system architecture? System architecture basically refers the way in which desired functionality is made by hardware and software component, as well as how these components relate to each other and the intended user of the system. Means system architecture is basically referred the desired functionality of the hardware and software, means whether the we have to make a software such that it can be function on given hardware. We don't make such software. If we made such softwares which are not working on your hardware, then what is the use of that? So suppose a software is there which is using the RAM of 1 GB according to user, and if you made the software which are requiring 8 GB of RAM, then what's use of that? So we have to make the analysis of that architecture, that we have to desired functionality, and we have to make that components relate to each other. Suppose we are making software, so we have to compensate, or we have to make work this according to the user, the hardware and software. This all the requirements of three, or all the requirement of desired functionality of three should be met. requirement is there, service and subsystem is there, interoperability and integration is there, software hardware is there, and vision. It is a system consistent parts, means you can subdivide it into subsystem like that. Now third one is application architecture. That what is the application architecture? Application architecture is really a subset of system architecture. I mean, just when the we have described the system architecture, that they have to meet the desired functionality of user, software, hardware, and users. So it's a subset of system architecture. The scope of the application architecture, as opposed to the system architecture, is often defined by the business function. Means, for example, you have developing any application part for any software industry. So it's a part of system architecture because it have to be work in a system. So the scope of application architecture is opposed to the system architecture, means it have to be work according to the system architecture. Okay, suppose you are making a WhatsApp or Facebook or any kind of application, then it should have to work according to the system's architecture. You should not have to make a system that half of the functionality shouldn't appear on the system. Then what is the use of that application? So you have to make the architecture such that they have to be managed its process or the procedures with the given softwares or given system architecture. So it's the same what we have, that it may have classes, components, subtypes, design patterns should be taken care according to this. Then software framework and library should be there, and the vision we have to make. Okay, so guys, if you have any kind of queries, then you can mention in our comment section, and please subscribe us so that you can get further notification from our side, and press the bell icon button so that you can get instant notification from our side. Thank you so much, guys.
Hello guys, welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we will discuss about the approaches of the information architecture, that is the top down and bottom up. There are two approaches of information architecture. In this video we will discuss in detail about them. Okay, so guys, please subscribe us so that you can get more updates from our channel, and press the bell icon button also so that you can get instant notification from our channel whenever we will upload a new video. So guys, let's come up to the topic, that is the information architect approaches. So what are the types of approaches? There are two types of approaches and information architecture here, that is the top down and the bottom up. Okay, so let's discuss about the what are the top down approach and what are the bottom up approaches. So in top down approaches, it involves developing a broad understanding of the business strategies and user needs. Okay, so business strategies and user needs and broad understanding of that is a very important point here before defining the high level structure. Okay, so before defining high level structure in any kind of project, development of broad understanding between business strategies and user needs is important. So in top down approach of an information architect or architecture, what happens is it involves a broad understanding of business strategy, that this project is wherever is needed in business. Suppose there is a project of telecom company. So suppose 4G is there or 5G is there, then how it will enhance the business strategy, what are the necessary requirements of other companies behind their project, what are the competition your company is providing to other companies, and what are the gaining profit or losing profit this will make into the market, what are the share capability, and each and every aspect of business strategy related to that model or that project. So this approach is involves that before developing that approach, it involves developing a broad understanding of business strategy and user needs, that how user will use that or whether this requirement a user will have or not. So the understanding of business strategy and user need before defining a high level structure means you didn't define the level of structure here now, but after the gaining of the proper business strategy and user needs, you have to define the high level architecture. So this type of information architecture approach is came under the top down information architecture. Okay, and then after getting the broad understanding between business strategies and user need, finally the detailed relationship among content will be developed. Similarly, if you will take in bottom up approach of the information architecture, it involves understanding the detailed relationship among contents. Okay, so what are the contents or detailed
contents in a project will have, you have to understand that first. After that, the detailed relationship among the contents you have to made and create walkthrough to show how the system could support specific user requirements, and then consider the higher level structure that will be required to support these requirements. Means what you have to do in the bottom up approach is it involves the understanding of the detailed relationship among contents, that what are the content of that information system have or what are the content of that project have. You have to make a detailed relationship among the content, that what are the relationship between contents have. Means you have to divide it in subsystem, then some modules and like objects, and you have to compare them and you have to make a detailed relationship between them. After that, you have to create a storyboard or walkthrough to show how the system could support specific user requirements. Means suppose any specific user requirements came there, then how could this specific user requirements could be useful by that detailed relationship. And after that, you have to make the higher level structure to required for support this requirement. So this is the bottom up approach. So guys, not top down and or bottom up approach, but it is not a mutually exclusive. Means every project includes both, because the criteria of the all the area of any project is very big. You can't express the whole project in via top down approach, or you can't approach the whole process via bottom up. So you have to need both processes, because in a project there are many type of modules there. So in any module, suppose there is requirement of top down, and in any module suppose there is requirement of bottom up. So it's not mutually exclusive, the both processes are required. Okay, so guys, we have just discussed here the approaches. Okay, approaches of information architecture, that is the top down approach and bottom up approaches. So I think it's very clear from our side. Further, if you have any kind of query, then please subscribe us and please press the bell icon button so that you can get more updates, and please comment us your query so that we can solve your query as early as possible. Thank you so much guys. Welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we will discuss about the information architect skills and experience. Okay, so what are the experience and the skills needed, we will discuss about that. So guys, please subscribe our channel so that you can get the latest information from our channel, and please press the bell icon button so that whenever we will upload a new video, you will get instant updation from our side. So guys, let's start. The qualities an information architect must have in a software industry. So the first and most important quality is strong customer focus. So strong customer focus is very important quality or the skill that an information architect must have. The information architect must know the focus of the customer, that what the customer want, what is the requirement of customer, what customer exact wants. The client's need is very important in software industries, because whatever is permanent is the client. You have to make such a category, you have to make such a focus on client that whenever he requires anything new, he again come to you. Means the focus on the customer requirement is the strongest point an information architect must have. The second skill is product knowledge. Okay, suppose any customer is requiring any specific product, then you must know about that product, that how many industries supplying that product, what are the cost of that product, what are the management of product, how they organize that product, what are the profit and that criteria of taxes in of that product. Okay, how fastly you can provide that product, what are the requirements to make that product. So all the product knowledge an information architect must have. The third and most important skill is knowledge of information design principles. Suppose any type of information system that user wants, so information architect must have the knowledge of information design principles. Suppose any new requirement come, then how to design that requirement or how to implement a project on that requirement, we will have to know about that. The important skill, have 3 to 5 years of technical writing. So after this experience, an information architect is capable of doing the requirement or doing the necessary technical writing there. Means if instantly suppose anything new have come, then by using his experience, the information architect can use his capabilities to work over that new product. So it's a very important skill or the experience that can be needed. Management and delivery. Management and delivery is very important, because if product is ready, but without management of that product and delivery, it can't be of useful. So management of that product is very important technique, and we must have to know that what are the criteria of that management. Okay, so an information architect's skill is management and delivery also. The next one is good interpersonal skills. Okay, so if an architect have a good interpersonal skills, then it can be used to solve that product in the market. Okay, and interpersonal skills may be useful in every criteria. You can't define it any specifically, but it's the common thing that an information architect must have. The next one is knowledge of user needs and usability assessment techniques. Okay, so suppose any user is giving his requirement, then you must add it. No sir, you can add this thing also, because it will more beneficial to you if you will get that. Suppose anyone is taking tea from tea leaves from any shop, then you can add such thing like that. Sir, please take this product, because it, if you will take that, then along with it you can also get a biscuit packet free or a coffee or tea mug free. So this capability or the user assessment techniques must have information architect, so that the company's growth may be more. The next one is demonstrated ability to work in a team environment. Because if you don't have any ability to work in a team, then how would you make that information architect, or how would you make architecture? Because architecture is only possible if you know each and every aspect of that product, and the only way to know each and every aspect of that product is discussion, and in discussion the importance of teamwork is there. So demonstrated ability to work in a team environment is necessary. The next one is ability to perform need analysis. Means you must have a ability to perform the need analysis. Means on the need, you must have your analysis plan, that after analysis you can survive the user's requirement, that okay, if this is the need, then according to your analysis you can add further more architecture or further more needs to the user, or you can place them better in such software industry environment. So guys, this is the information architect skills and experience that must one have if he or she wants to an information architect. Okay, so this type of questions can be asked directly in any type of questions or any type of examinations, that what kind of skills or experience a user must have in UGCNET exam, in IBPS IT officer exam, okay, or in any type of CS exam. Then from the information system or information architecture, this can be asked directly. So I think that these points you can not bypass the video, and further if you have any kind of query, then you can comment us so that we can provide you solution. So thank you so much guys, have a nice day. Please subscribe us so that you can get more updates.
Hello guys, so welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video we will discuss about the information architecture's impact on business. Okay, so guys, please subscribe our YouTube channel so that you can get more updates from our side, and please press the bell icon button also so that you can get instant notifications from our side. So guys, let's start with our today's topic, that is the information architecture's impact on business. So the first impact is customers consistently request. What are the, it is under the impact. Okay, so the impact is, first the customer consistently requests. If you have a better or suitable information architecture, then the first impact on any kind of business is that customers consistently request. Means if customer orders you a service, then in ahead of future or in onwards future also, he will consistently request you to design a product. So it's the basic advantage or the information architecture's impact. It's better retrievability. Means if you have better information architecture, then better chances of retrievability of the customer will be there. Solution oriented information is there, means specifically to the problem you have specific solution oriented information is there. A seamless information is there. If you in future, if any kind of
information a customer or client wants according to the project or module or in any kind of business strategy, then you have that seamless information there. And experience across product, because what the advantage of information architect is that you have that information. After designing so much product, you will get the experience across product, that what product needs what type of architecture, what is their usability, and how it provide the competition to marketers, and what is there is need of that product, or what the enhancement we can make. So such kind of impacts on businesses under there. In the first point, we have discussed the customers consistently request, so it's a very basic impact on business strategy. The second and important is the good information architecture can fulfill those requests. Means if you have consistently request, then good information architecture can fulfill that request. Okay, it will reduce the total cost of ownership. Why it will reduce? Because it will take you once or twice to make that information architecture. But if further it will come, then you don't have to design that information architecture. Okay, you already have that one in a very better quality. Okay, so it will reduce the total cost of ownership. Second one is that reduce customer support calls, because if you have maintenance, then in two or twice or thrice ways they can be solved, and after using continuously the same type of information architecture, the support call will be reduced. The third one is reduce number of non-defect customer support issues, because consistently if you will use that, then it's obvious that the defect chances will be less. And increase customer satisfaction, because if customer is satisfied with previous one product or previous architecture, then it will surely be satisfied with this one also, because you have made a huge amount of enhancement in that, so that it will also customer satisfied. The third impact is all information developers can work toward these goals in their information deliverables and contribute to the overall information architecture. Okay, so suppose there is a module or there is a product, so the information developers will work toward that goals. Okay, they will work togetherly and they will work toward the goals to deliver that contribution. Okay, they will contribute from themselves to solve the overall information architecture. Okay, so these are the three impacts. What are the three impacts? It will customer consistently will request, and good information architecture can fulfill those requests, and information developers will contribute to overall information architectures. Okay, so these three impacts are there, and we have also discussed them in very detail. So further, if you have any kind of query, you can comment us so that we can solve your query very fast, as early as possible. Further, please subscribe our channel so that you can get more updates from our side, and press the bell icon button so that you can get instant updation from our side. Thank you so much, guys. Have a
welcome
nice day.
To our YouTube channel. In this video, we will discuss about the TOGAF, that is the TOGAF, the Open Group Architecture Framework. Okay, so it provides an easy and efficient information architecture. Why it is needed and what are its architecture model, we will discuss all these aspects here. So guys, before the discussion, I just want to tell you one thing, that please subscribe our channel so that you can get more updates from our side very free, and please press the bell icon button also so that whenever we will upload a new content, you will get instant notification from our channel. So guys, let's come to our topic, that is the TOGAF. Okay, so what is the TOGAF? TOGAF is abbreviated for the Open Group Architecture Framework. Okay, it provides an easy and efficient information architecture. Okay, because in previous version, what happened is that to create an information architecture, this is very expensive, very complicated, have many complexities, and maybe not accurate enough as according to the user requirement. So the TOGAF is came here. It is an architecture framework. Okay, the Open Group Architecture Framework, it enables you to design, evaluate and build the right architecture for your organization for which you work. Okay, so to design architecture for any type of organization, the TOGAF will help you to design, evaluate and build the right architecture. So let's discuss first that what TOGAF is all about. It's a generic. Okay, so this framework is very generic. It is a process driven, so it's work on process driven methodologies.
it's one size fits all organization. Okay, means the one size of a project or the framework will fits to the all its organization. It's a flexible framework. Okay, so it's not difficult at all, and anyone can work here. Set of conceptual tools. Okay, so you just need to learn these tools. So it is a set of conceptual tools to make the information architecture. TOGAF provide generic deliverables. Okay, so it will provide the generic deliverables. So it is the all about TOGAF. Now we will discuss what TOGAF is not. It is not the perspective about how to customize the framework. Okay, it's also not about perspective or artifact driven, that what is the input of artifact is simply means the what are the input of the one state, and it will goes to as a what are the output of one state, and it will goes as an input to the other state. And it is not all about specific to company size or an industry. It's not also ontology driven, and it's not tool, it's a framework, and it is not for prescribing a specific set of deliverables. Okay, so TOGAF is all about generic deliverables, conceptual tools, set flexible, it will fit into the all its organizations. This is a process driven and generic. So TOGAF developing an architecture. Okay, so you can see here that suppose you have to vision that architecture first, that what all the architecture is all about. After that, if you know about that, then as it is you can make it, and then if there is gap or any kind of information is not there, then you can take certain actions on there, and if it is suitable then okay, then if not then you further can retrieve here. And if vision is to be according to the need, then also you can go like this way. So it is a simple developing an architecture method. Process, business processes or functions is here. After that, design is here. Then application components, then technical infrastructure. Okay, technical infrastructure, if you have implemented that, then you will also get the application components. So we will discuss about the information architecture process. Okay, so what is the information architecture process? So it will consist basically of three main parts. What are the three main parts? The TOGAF architecture development method, ADM. Okay, architecture development method, the enterprises continuum, the TOGAF foundation architecture, the TOGAF standard information base, the TOGAF technical reference model, the integrated information infrastructure model, and the TOGAF resource base. So it is the three main parts. What are the three main parts? The ADM, that is the architecture development method, the second is the enterprise continuum, and the third one is the TOGAF resource base. Now we will see here the business strategy and requirement under the TOGAF framework. So basically it's the architecture, that business architecture is here, information architecture is here, application architecture is here, technical architecture is here. So it is a business reference model according based on the architectures. Then architectural development model is that we will discuss here. We will discuss it in detail also. And it is a government. So let's discuss the architecture development model, ADM, the first main part of the TOGAF. So it's a prelim. Suppose there is prelim framework and principles, then you have to for making that architecture on this open source, on this open group architecture framework, first you have to vision that. Then business architecture is there, then information system architecture is there, then you have to drive that information on any technology architecture. Then you have to make out suitable, found the opportunities and their solutions. Then migration planning is there, then implementation governance is there, then architecture change management is there, and these all are the requirements of any particular information architecture. Further you can expand it like prelims framework, architecture vision, business architecture, information system. You can here technology, in technology architecture which is here, you can further expand it like create baseline, then consider view, then create architecture model, then select services what you want, and confirm business objects, that what business objects required here, then determination criteria, define the architecture, then conduct gap analysis also, then opportunities and solutions are there. It is migration planning then. And this is the same as we have discussed in ADM. So it is the architecture driven method according to the TOGAF. Okay, so I think it's very clear from here that what the TOGAF is all about. It will consist of the three main parts, that is the TOGAF architecture development method, which we have discussed. The second one is enterprise continuum, and the third is TOGAF resource base. Okay, so it's the corporate based, means in the enterprises industry you can see such type of architecture. Suppose IT management is there, then in corporate leadership, if anyone have a strategy, then you can use the technical reference model. And this is just for information purpose, that if you are preparing for any exam preparation, then you can just basically know the idea of that architecture, that what it's all about. Okay, suppose it's for sales or marketing or R&D, production, whatever it is. Okay, so I think guys it's very clear about the TOGAF, that what it is all about. So guys, please, if you like that lecture, then please subscribe us, so that you can get more updates from our side. And we will try to provide your query solution also. If you have any kind of query, then comment us. Thank you so much guys, have a nice day.